This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Olivia and Kyle, welcome all who have gathered for this special day in their lives. You may be seated. We gather in the presence of God to give thanks for the gift of marriage, to witness the joining together of Olivia and Kyle, to surround them with our prayers and to ask God's blessing upon them so that they may be strengthened for their life together and nurtured in their love. God gave us marriage for the full expression of love between a husband and a wife. In marriage, each person belongs to the other, and with affection and tenderness, freely give themselves to each other. We rejoice that marriage is given by God and blessed by God and sustained by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, let marriage be held in high honor among all. Will you join me in a word of prayer? Lord, in this beautiful setting that we have here, we thank you for Kyle and Olivia and the love that they share with each other, because it reminds us of the love that you have for us and the love that we share with those that we care so much about. Bless them, Lord, not only in this moment, but each day, week, month, and year, their lives together. We ask this, Lord, in your Son's name. Who brings Olivia to be married today?
Chapter 12, verses 9 through 10. Let love be genuine, hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection, outdo one another in showing love.
Of all the relationships there are between human beings, parent to child, brother to sister, neighbor to neighbor, and so many more, none of these have received the same divine attention as the relationship between husband and wife. From the very beginning of Scripture, God blesses the union of two people in marriage, so I can say today that God will bless your union as well. I heard a song on the radio recently, and the lyrics caught my ear because of the way the song talked about love. In fact, I had to look it up so I could write it down, and it's from a song called A Moment Like This. And it reads, "A moment like this, some people wait a lifetime. For a moment like this, some people search forever. For that one special kiss, oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this." The scripture that Carter read said, "Love must be sincere, devoted to one another in love." In another letter written by the Apostle Paul, we read, "Love is patient, love is kind, it is not envious, jealous, and love never fails." This passage is read at many weddings because people think love, especially romantic love, that they are experiencing is what will keep them together. Well, it takes more. It takes more than love that is sung about by pop singers, love that is written by poets, and much more. Romantic love is what has brought you here today. This love is needed throughout your marriage, but it will not make your marriage. Romance is important, but a sound marriage needs more. Real love that lasts, the love that keeps marriages together, succeeds only when people work at it. Olivia, there are going to be days when you may need to work on being patient and kind. And Kyle, you may find times when you can't have it your way. And there will be days when those requirements are reversed. Some days will require more work than others. Never, ever let yourselves fall into the temptation of thinking that love is easy. Falling in love is the easy part. Keeping the flame of love burning requires effort. My point is simply this. You will have to work together and work hard to develop the kind of love that lasts. Part of working toward a lasting love is to daily demonstrate your love by what you do for the other person. This goes for Kyle and Olivia as well as all of us here. Never let your love die or fade into the background of good intentions or unspoken words. Show each other how you feel. Every day, do something to show your love for each other. It may be a kiss, a flower, a hug, a small gift, a touch, a kind word, or something else. But it will show your partner how much your love is real. You found each other while you were in college and working with children. You had great need. You were blessed because you put others before yourselves. Allow that to remain a very real part of your lives together, and you will find a richness that will bind you forever. Olivia and Kyle, your love for each other does not spring from you alone. The love you feel for each other comes from God who loved us first. Your vows are not just between the two of you. These vows are made in the presence of God. They include God, and it is God who will enable you to be faithful as you grow in love for each other. Olivia, since it is your intention to marry, I would ask that you join your hands and with your promises bind yourselves to each other as husband. I, Kyle, take you, Olivia.
I, Kyle, take you, Olivia.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise before God and these witnesses.
I promise before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving.
To be your loving.
And faithful husband.
Faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live. Olivia, take the call. Be my husband. I promise before God and these witnesses. Be your loving and faithful wife. In plenty and in want. In joy and in sorrow. In sickness and in health. As long as we both shall live. What do you bring as a sign of your promises? Bow with me for just a moment. Lord, we ask you to bless these rings. Not that there is any eternal value in the metal, but only in the love that they represent. The love between Kyle and Olivia that will be told to the world every time someone sees them. May this symbol, when they see it on each other's finger, be something to remind them of the deep love they share one for the other. Pray this in your son's name. God, and in the presence of each of you, Kyle and Olivia have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed their promises by the joining of hands and the exchanging of rings. Therefore, I proclaim that they are now husband and wife.
Oh yeah, that's the other one. Yeah, we didn't have any.